Hi everyone, my name is Orestis Plevrakis, and in this video I will talk about a joint work with Elad Hazan on a new geometric exploration algorithm for online control. We consider linear dynamical systems where there is a state that is evolving with time. The state at time t plus 1 is linear in the past state and linear in the control input at time t. There is also disturbance, which is assumed to be Gaussian. This model lies at the core of control theory and has tons of applications in robotics, autonomous vehicles, data center cooling, in finance, etc. The linear quadratic regulator problem is the simplest and most fundamental problem in control. We have our linear dynamical system and we define a policy pi to be a mapping from the current state to the current control input. The goal in LQR is to find the policy that minimizes a cumulative quadratic cost. The intuition behind the quadratic objective is that we want to keep the state small without applying large control inputs. This problem is very well understood and has a very elegant solution. Kalman in 1962 proved that if we care about the expected cost, the optimal policy is just a linear function given by some matrix k. The fact that the costs are quadratic is key to get this theorem. LQR is appealing because it has a simple solution. However, the modeling choice of quadratic costs is very restrictive. In 1987, Tyrell Rockefeller proposed the use of general convex costs in order to model constraints on the state and control. The reason is that constraints are crucial for ensuring safety in control. So, for a given convex function C, our goal is to find the policy that minimizes the cumulative cost. However, there is a price for this generality. The optimization problem is intractable, and the optimal policy can be a very complicated function. A way to circumvent this is by searching over policies from a policy class that is both expressive and tractable. A natural choice is the class of linear policies. The reason is that linear policies are expressive since, as I said, they are optimal when the cost is quadratic. Furthermore, the theory community does not currently know how to deal with non-linear policy classes, and this is a very good direction for future work. Now, we are ready to describe the problem that our work is about, and which has been studied in recent years from the learning theory community. It is the problem of online control of a linear dynamical system with convex costs. Here, we don't know the system matrices A and B, so we want to control and learn the system simultaneously. We will assume that the cost function is known. So, the system for us is a black box, and we interact with it by observing the current state xt and then applying the control ut. When we do this, we pay the corresponding cost. So what is our goal? Our goal will be to do as well as the best linear policy, which applies controls given by a linear function of the current state. Formally, our objective is policy regret, which is our total cost minus the total cost paid by the best linear policy. Because we don't know the system, there is really an explore versus exploit trade-off here. In the last years, there has been intense interest for this problem, both for the case of linear quadratic regulator, which is the case of quadratic costs, and for general convex costs. The reason is that linear dynamical systems have emerged as a standard benchmark for continuous control and reinforcement learning. For the case where the cost is a strongly convex quadratic function, Simkovitz and Foster pinned down the optimal regret and completed the story for online LQR. However, their work had a surprising takeaway, which was that naive exploration is optimal for strongly quadratic costs. When I say naive exploration, I mean the following strategy. We play random controls for some number of steps, then we use the gathered observations to estimate the system matrices, and then we execute the optimal policy for the estimated system until the end. This is the analog of epsilon greedy in reinforcement learning, and this is why this is a surprising result. Epsilon greedy is in general a bad strategy in reinforcement learning, while here it is optimal. As it can be seen from the analysis, strong convexity of the cost is the key property behind this result, which can be generalized for strongly convex costs. So, this begs the question, what if we don't have strong convexity? This is an important question because non-strongly convex costs, like piecewise linear costs, are useful for modeling constraints, and constraints are crucial for safety in control. Now, it can be shown that naive exploration is suboptimal for general convex costs and gives t⅔ regret. However, this is the only algorithm that we know for this problem. All the papers which go beyond LQR and consider general convex costs do exactly this. The question is, can we go beyond naive exploration and achieve root regret? I have to say that for LQR, there have been papers that proposed more sophisticated exploration schemes based on the principle of optimism in the face of uncertainty. However, it is intractable to implement these schemes when we have general convex costs. Our first and main result is a new geometric exploration strategy that runs in polynomial time and achieves d⁵ times root regret for a known system and known cost function. This resolves the question that I described previously. We also consider the case where the cost function is also unknown, and the way the learner gets information about the cost is by observing the scalar cost at each step. We design a new polynomial time algorithm that achieves poly d times root regret for this problem. In this video, I will talk only about our main result, where the cost is known. I am happy to talk about the second result at the poster session. I should note that we make the standard assumption that the algorithm has access to an initial stabilizing policy that prevents an unstable system from exploding. To give a taste of our exploration strategy, I will focus on the special case where there are no dynamics, meaning that the matrix A is zero. So, the state is just a linear function of the control plus the Gaussian disturbance. We also assume for simplicity that the cost depends only on the state. The natural goal here is to compete with the best fixed control that has bounded norm, for some norm bound R. The regret is our total cost minus t times the expected cost of the best control. So, the matrix B is unknown, the convex cost is known, and we get information about B by observing xt. Observe that this special case is a clean bandit problem, which to the best of our knowledge was not studied previously. For this special case, our algorithm has the following form. It runs in epochs and it maintains a convex set of controls that we will call U and which contains the optimal control U star. Also, U shrinks at the end of its epoch. In the picture, you can see an example of how this convex set evolves in three consecutive epochs. The important step is that in the beginning of each epoch, the algorithm computes a barycentric spanner of the convex set U, which is a set of d vectors where d is the dimension. Roughly, this is a basis of the convex set U that can express all its elements using small coefficients. In the figure, the two controls, U1 and U2, are the elements of a barycentric spanner for this convex set. In the paper, we show how to compute this basis for the convex sets that we construct in polynomial time using the ellipsoid method. For the rest of the epoch, we execute the controls that belong to this basis several times each. By applying these controls, we generate states that give information about the directions of the matrix B that are most relevant for the current set of controls U. This information allows us to eliminate suboptimal controls and further shrink our set U. Now, the general case where the system matrix A is not zero is more challenging. First, the search is over policies, not controls. But it can be shown that the cost as a function of the policy is non-convex. To remedy this, we employ a recently proposed convex relaxation. However, this relaxation requires that we know the disturbances, which are unknown to us. We resolve this issue by showing that learning the disturbances is much easier than learning the dynamics, and it does not require any exploration, which is pretty nice. Please come to the poster session to talk more about our new algorithms and techniques, and also discuss several open questions. Thank you very much.